In a world of increasing political correctness, Harley-Davidson stands out as a rebellious motorcycle manufacturer. Its answer to global warming, for instance, is a 1,745cc V-twin that produces 144 Nm of torque. Traffic congestion, did you say? How about a bike that's 2.3 meters long and weighs over 300 kg? As for body shaming, well, this one's still called the Fat Boy.
The Harley-Davidson Fat Boy has been overhauled for 2018 and we're grateful for it. While it's identical to the older Fat Boy in its silhouette, it now looks modern and finish levels are up too. The LED headlight, beefy wide handlebar, an imposing engine and an overall stance that spells unapologetic muscle result in a motorcycle that's utterly desirable. Its 670mm seat height makes heaving its curb weight around easier than you'd think, and it's actually a friendly motorcycle to ride regularly once you break the ice with it. On the Fat Boy, you don't need a key for any function except the manual steering lock, which takes away from the keyless experience to some extent.
What you get is the iconic Fat Boy attitude, but now in a more contemporary package. It has the presence and the visual mass, and with all the shiny bits covered in satin finish rather than chrome, it looks elegant and yet inimitably American.
The Fat Boy is a sensory treat you'll never tire of if you're a diehard cruiser fanatic. The Milwaukee 8 engine admirably retains the characteristic and likeable V-twin vibrations while largely ironing out ones that aren't quite so. Even the clutch is reasonably weighed, and in traffic too, it's easy to use despite the lack of adjustability. If you're in a rush, the Fat Boy will be happy to get you from standstill to 100 km per hour in just 4.7 seconds. For a motorcycle of this size, the Fat Boy has serious grunt, and while it can't match the Ducati X-Diavel on this front, it's thrilling enough in the realm of sanity.
The 1745cc Milwaukee 8 engine is aggressive when you need it to be, but otherwise is at home being ridden at 100 km per hour in 6th gear. Harley has definitely made a leap in terms of making this engine more highway friendly, although low speed gearing isn't exactly ideal. That said, Harley purists will enjoy the mechanical feel of this gearbox.
I didn't expect the Fat Boy to be a ravishing handling package, and it isn't, but it's surprisingly good. The redesigned chassis on the new Softail family is 65% stiffer and also facilitates increased lean angles and a more precise steering. You still end up scraping the footboards when leaning ambitiously, but the ease with which you can bank the Fat Boy into a corner is what is addictive. Braking is absolutely phenomenal, especially for a motorcycle of this weight, and that it can get from 100 km per hour to a dead halt in just 3.4 seconds should tell you how impressive it is. The brakes are not only prompt but also predictable, and the lever progression is good for either brake. What adds to the Fat Boy's premiumness is the suspension. For 2018, Harley-Davidson has equipped the Softails with the Showa dual bending valve fork previously seen on the touring range. This isn't just a lighter fork, but also provides more comfortable damping without making the steering lethargic by its class standards. Also new is the underseat monoshock, which absorbs most bumps decently without unsettling the rider and is definitely an improvement over the twin shocks on the older bike. Ground clearance, however, is set at a low 115mm, so you'll have to take it easy over most speed breakers.
Overall, the ride quality isn't outstanding, but for a bike this long in low, it's surprisingly usable. What's fun, however, is what the Fat Boy feels like in the corners. Despite a 160 section front tire, which is as wide as the rear tire on a Kawasaki Ninja 650, this bike is relatively easy to flick into corners. And with all that torque on tap, a speedy exit is always guaranteed.
Is the Fat Boy still an irresistible cruiser to splurge on? Yes, as long as you don't have a pillion that features in your motorcycling dreams. I had a go at riding pillion, and it was an unforgiving experience that became intolerable beyond 10 minutes, especially without an optional backrest.
The Fat Boy is menacing to look at, and is extremely fulfilling if all you want is to make a statement. It's also a lot more fun to ride now, and I'm sure Arnold Schwarzenegger would be proud.